Hey guys, it's Bill here. I've started school, so I'm not going to be uploading as much. I never uploaded anyway, so yeah, it's rare that I upload, so yeah. That's the volume for the music, it's okay. I'm going to be reading another story, and I'm going to be updating all the other stories I've been reading, because, yeah. Anyways, this is called Oh Brother. Yes, this is incest, but sort of not incest. They're step-siblings. So this is, again, on my favorite website in the world, Quibi. And I'll put my link down in the description. Also, this story was made by Bookworm. This is copyrighted by her. She owns the whole storyline and didn't use anyone that is famous. So, yeah. So let's start on chapter one because I don't want to read the description. My dad narrowed that. I have a problem with reading. Okay. My eyes narrowed at the boy who was helping his dad carry the computer into my house, into the house, my house. The place he and his dad would be living in, maybe forever. I felt nauseous at the thought. The boy, Christian Woods, was a golden boy. And his dad was now my mom's husband. You see, after 2 years of hiding a relationship with a man named Stephen Woods, my mom told me she would be marrying him in 2 months. My jaw dropped at those words. The same as my heart. I hated change, especially unexpected change. My eyes darted away as Christian and his dad walked into the house, holding the large computer together. Once they walked past me, I decided to glare at Christian as he carefully walked up the stairs with his dad. Surprisingly, I hated Christian more than Stefan. Even though Stefan was the reason why change happened, for some reason, I just couldn't stand Christian. Not at all due to his golden boy glory and his instruction of my life. In a few minutes, Stefan and Christian walked back downstairs. Once again, my eyes darted away so that I was looking at the ground. Neither of them deserved the idea of me looking at them. Christian, you could take a break, I heard Stefan say. There's not much left. I can finish up. Are you sure, Dad? Yeah. I heard Stefan's boots thud in my direction to where I heard the front door. He was a large man, made of all muscle and broad bone. You always know when he's around. Poor Stefan left the house. He suddenly said, "Hey, Autumn." "Hi," I muttered, only to be polite. Stefan was a nice guy. He made my mom happy and brought me things, so I didn't really hate him. I hated what he'd done to my life, but I didn't necessarily hate him. Once Stefan left, I lifted my head to watch him go back to the moving truck. He was 40 and still looking somewhat young, with his neat black hair and lively features of bright blue eyes and a big smile. A big, perfect smile. If I was my mom's age, I might have seen what she saw in him. still watching him and her footsteps near me. There was only one person in the house right now. I know who it was, the very person I despised. The person who was causing my blood to boil in my veins. "Autumn," he said, surprisingly gentle. The way he spoke to me was always like that, much to my annoyance. It seemed like he didn't want to hurt me. It seemed like he thought I was delicate little thing. But that was the most many reasons why I hated him. "What?" I asked, looking at him, emphasized my annoyance. Quickly I raked my eyes over him, as if to sum him up. Christian looked at his father and back at the same time. He definitely had his father's bright blue eyes and chiseled facial structure, but wasn't as built or as hard as Stefan. He was like a softer version, with lean muscles and younger appearance, with a soft-looking skin, unlike his dad, who he also has messy hair and was slightly taller. "Autumn," he kept saying in a gentle tone. I jumped up. I snapped out of my thoughts, remembering we were in the middle of a conversation. "This is what happened. With everyone else, I would have to blush. I know you're not happy," he continued. "But I hope we can get along. My dad and your mom are happy together, and there's nothing that we can do to change that. Let's try to be family." I scoffed, narrowing my eyes at him. Christian knew I hated him. Everyone with eyes would be able to tell that I did. It was all obvious. It was that obvious. So the idea of all of us getting along was laughable. "Look," I even said with a fake smile, "we are never going to get along. I'm not even going to try. We're going to just pretend the other doesn't exist. Okay?" He stared at me tiredly. "Autumn, we are now family. I'm your brother." I sucked in a breath, knowing I would lose it if I didn't. From what my mom went on about, Christian was smart, kind, handsome, and athletic. Seeing what he just said, doubted he was smart. "You are not my brother," I said, hissing. Wait, I hid. "You and Stefan are not my family." I stormed off, tired of talking to him. He's the only reason why I was unhappy right now. He was the only person that I hated with passion in this world. Getting along with him? Impossible. Time skip. I'm home. I heard my mom yell, getting off the bed, rushing downstairs. I had been bored to death. And thankfully, she was here. I blah, 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 blah. Especially when I could smell Chinese food. Oh my gosh. As I rush down straight, narrow stairs that separated the clean kitchen from the living room, I took a quick turn to my left to go to the kitchen. My face nearly smashed into someone's chest wearing a black V-neck. I growled. and I growled. I'm just gonna say growled. I knew who the person was. Moved, I said, staring up at him. Christian slightly seemed amused, and as he stepped aside, as usual, my blood began to boil from the side of this boy. This is stupid. Life-ruining boy. Autumn, don't give Christian an attitude. You heard your mom say. You're the one who clearly crashed into him. I looked to where my mom stood, right in front of Stefan, his arms wrapped around her waist, snuggling into the crook of her neck. I felt like I was going to gag at the sign. But, Mom! Mom said sternly. You need to learn how to treat them with respect. We are a family now. They are not my family. I sat. Stefan lifted his face from my mom's neck, looking sad as he stared at me now. My heart clenched with guilt, but I pushed away the feeling. They deserve this. They deserve my wrath. My mom sighed tiredly, as she'd seen me like this before at the wedding. That was the first time I met the two of them. When I did meet them, I was rude, harsh, and unwelcoming. My mom caught on to that, and she lectured me thoroughly throughout the party. I didn't listen to a word she said, though. I'm not even my mom. My mom seemed to be giving up on the view of that. Autumn, let's eat as a family. My mom eventually said, Come here. I robotically marched up to where my mom stood. Stefan let go of her and smiled sadly at me. I averted my eyes and watched the cushion left. He's such a good boy, my mom said to Stefan. It was kind of him to go get my car keys. He's my son, Stefan teased. My mom giggled like a little girl. I found myself wanting to grow up again. And this time, on both of them, seeing my mom like that was strange. Bizarre, because she had never been a strong, independent woman. Now that Stefan came into the picture, that trait of hers has demolished. Christian soon came back and a small smile on his face. Despite wearing all black and being an 18, he looked surprisingly young. When he smiled, younger than my age of 16. Why haven't you guys started eating? Christian asked, handing the car keys to my mom. We were waiting for you, my mom replied, taking the car keys. Thank you so much, Christian. I looked up at my mom, feeling like someone jabbed into my heart, and now twisting it slowly. The way my mom looked at Christian was the way my mom should be looking at me. A look of love and adoration and protectiveness and care. My mom never looked at me like that. Not since Stefan seemed to come into the picture. Well, let's all dig in, Stefan said. Everyone smiled similarly, except me. Throughout the day, they all smiled except for me. I felt wanting to be alone for the day. My mom wouldn't allow that though. I was stuck beside the boy I hated and his father I wanted gone. And that bad feeling, this shows how my life would be ruined from now on. That was a pretty good story, huh? I didn't stutter as much as I did on the other one. color because I am wearing contacts now. Anyway, yeah, that was the story, old brother. Okay, I'm gonna go and maybe upload another one tomorrow. Okay, thank you for watching. I am Fearless, and I'm out.